I've received a number of requests to provide some additional information on plane waves at normal incidence. So tonight I'm going to do a video on writing the field equations in our three-layer region. For more details, you can go to the class website and find the additional lectures. This lecture complements Lecture 26, Plane Wave Reflections at Normal Incidence. The model that we are considering is a three-layer region with a plane wave incident on it. Here's Region 1, here's Region 2, and here's Region 3. We define origins for each of these regions, shown here, and distances, minus D2 and minus D1. Here's our plane wave incident from left to right. That's the direction of propagation, the squiggly line. Let's say that the electric field is polarized in this direction. This is the incident electric field, and let's define it here at O1. So this is going to be E incident at O1. Let's say that it's given that E incident 1 at O1 is 1 volt per meter with a phase of phi degrees. We can write that as 1 volt per meter, that's the magnitude, e to the j phi. Now we want to write the total electric field in region 1. The total electric field in region 1 as a function of the direction of propagation, let's say that's x, is going to be made up of the incident field plus the reflected field. Let's say that this is the y direction, because we're going to need that in order to figure out the polarizations. So the incident field is going to have three parts. It's going to have a magnitude, a phase, and a polarization term. The magnitude is going to be given by E incident at O1. Let's just take its magnitude. That's the 1 volt per meter. And then that's going to attenuate as e to the minus alpha 1 x, because that's the direction of propagation, alpha 1 because we're in region number 1, and minus because we're going from left to right. So here's our magnitude term. Our phase term is going to have two parts. One is the e to the j phi that's associated with our incident field. The other term is the propagation term, e to the minus j beta 1 x. Beta 1 could also be written as k1 and x because we have the direction of propagation minus because we're going from left to right. And j terms represent phase shift. So here's our magnitude. Here's our phase or propagation term. And then last but not least, we're going to have the polarization term. The polarization term tells us which direction the solid line associated with the electric field vector is. In this case, we can see that that is y polarized. Now let's consider the reflected field. The reflected field is going to be E incident, O1, times the reflection coefficient. The reflection coefficient that we always use, regardless of where we are looking for the field, at least in region 1, is the reflection coefficient 1 at O1. And then we need the propagation term, or the propagation loss, which is e to the alpha 1 x. This time it's plus, because it's going from right to left. So here is our magnitude term. Now let's look at the phase term. The phase term is still going to have e to the j phi, but now it also has a phase associated with reflection coefficient. So this is going to be e to the j and then the phase of gamma 1 at O1. Our propagation term is going to be e to the plus j beta 1 x, plus because we're going from right to left. Now let's look at the polarization. When the reflected field happens, the electric field polarization stays the same. You're going to find that the magnetic field polarization will change, but the reflected field polarization is going to stay in the y direction. Now, the version of the electric field that we have here is written in the frequency domain. We can see it's in the frequency domain because we have j's, and these phase terms are represented as complex exponents. If we would like to convert to the time domain, what we want is something like a cosine of omega t plus a bunch of phase shifts. That's what's going to happen here. So we're going to take each of these phase shifts and plug them into the cosine term. So it's going to be cosine of omega t plus phi plus angle of gamma 1 at O1 plus beta 1 x. Notice that there are no j's in a time domain form. So The time domain form of this field uses exactly the same magnitude, replaces the complex exponents with a cosine term, and then uses exactly the same polarization. This term up here we also have to convert to a cosine term. That is going to be cosine of omega t plus phi minus beta 1 x. So this is the total electric field in region number 1. We find that we have two terms, E incident and E reflected. They are written up here. They always have a magnitude term, a phase or a propagation term, and a polarization term. Sum these two fields, and that is the total field in region number 1. We can write it in the frequency domain using complex exponents, or in the time domain by converting the complex exponent terms to cosine of omega t terms. In the next video, let's write the expression for the total magnetic field in region number 1.